While hotspot volcanism and cataclysmic volcanic eruptions are responsible for the landscape around Yellowstone, it's probably best known for its hydrothermal features, the largest collection in the world, a great example of which is the Grand Prismatic Spring just behind me. These hydrothermal features are located throughout the park, and they require certain things to be in place for their existence. Of course, they require a good water source, and they require a heat source, which is provided by magma very close to the surface in a thin crust. And then they require a plumbing system or a network of fractures. And these fractures are created by earthquake activity associated with the uplift and the collapse of the caldera. So where these three things come together, a network of fractures or faults, and hot water provided by groundwater supplies from snow, melt, and rainfall, and then finally the heat source needed to warm things up, the hot water appears at the surface. And there are really four variations on these hydrothermal features, and they're controlled by the amount of water and the configuration of the plumbing system, or the fractures, if you will. In the case of hot springs, there's an ample supply of water, and many of these hot springs show, like the Grand Prismatic, a zonation of colors. The hottest water is in the center of the spring and is generally clear or blue, but in the Grand Prismatic Spring we see a rainbow effect around the margins of the spring. And these colors are due to thermophiles, or heat-loving bacteria. These thermophiles are adapted to varying temperatures of water, and that's reflected in the coloration that we see. So the coolest water thermophiles are usually the orange and the brown ones that you see around the margin, and then there'll be a zonation of colors in between. So that's what's responsible for the beautiful colors here in these hot springs. Well, hot springs have ample supply of water and no constriction in the plumbing system, so the water is free to flow out to the surface. Mammoth Hot Springs is another famous example of hot spring activity in Yellowstone. A second type of hydrothermal features are the geysers. In geysers, there is a constriction in the plumbing system, a nozzle, if you will, and typically the water underneath that constriction will superheat. It'll reach temperatures above boiling, and then with a slight pressure drop, that water will flash into steam and expand quickly and force all the water that's above it out through the nozzle in a jet-like fashion, or a geyser. Old Faithful, of course, is a famous example, probably the most famous in the park, but geysers are found all over the park with varying eruption cycles and times of eruptions. A third type of hydrothermal feature are mud pots. Mud pots have a limited supply of water, no real constriction in the plumbing system, but the groundwater is typically acidic, and so it breaks down the rhyolite or the bedrock into chemical constituents and creates a thick, soupy-like mud, and the consistency can change over the season. Later in the season, these mud pots get thicker and thicker as they dry up. Fountain paint pots in Yellowstone is a famous example of mud pots. And finally, the fourth example of hydrothermal features in the park are fumaroles, or steam vents. Steam vents occur when there's a very limited supply of water, but it's found at extremely high temperatures, and so vapor or steam emits from fractures on the surface. And we see these littered all over the park as well. So in Yellowstone, hydrothermal features are controlled by the presence of faults associated with earthquake activity, with a water supply provided by rainfall and snowmelt, and finally by the presence of magma beneath a thin crust associated with the Yellowstone hotspot.